Teddy Feinberg, Brooke Stockburger, T&B Show. That stands for Teddy and Brooke. Coming at you from the Las Cruces Sun News Garden.
I still refer to it as the Brooke and Teddy Show, but that's another thing.
Brooke and Teddy Show.
A little distracted today. We're outside. See, Italian Bistro is not too far down the road, and I can smell garlic in the air.
It does. It smells incredible. It really
it's making
does.
Me super hungry for some pasta.
I know.
Chicken parm. But anyway.
Back to sports. Let's get the ball rolling. I think we want to talk conference realignment, if memory serves. Obviously, the Conference USA, the Mountain West merger, the Aggies. Do you see them having a home in this particular arena?
I would love for that to happen, but I have a bad feeling it won't.
Yeah.
UTEP's going to be in the conference, and I'm sure, I haven't talked to any of the folks down there, but I'm sure UTEP would not want the Aggies in.
It seems like historically they've blocked them.
Right, and they don't want a rival 40, 50 miles up the road to be in the same conference. And I have a hard time seeing the Aggies get into that, you know, the new amalgam of the Conference USA and Mountain West.
Can I just pick up where you left off? Because I think you bring up a good point, actually. I don't think the Aggies have made themselves marketable enough for that conference. I mean, what are conferences looking for? They're looking for TV markets, and that's out of the Aggies' hands. We live in Las Cruces. We all know that. They do have Aggie vision. But they're also looking for quality football.
Yep.
And the Aggies, I think, are two consecutive winning seasons away from putting together, you know, a marketable football program in that respect. And I think they're looking for an overall athletics investment. And just my personal opinion, I don't think they've invested enough in their athletics department. I think there's more quality Western Athletic Conference team. These are some guests of ours. Hey guys, have a great day. I think there's more marketable WAC teams. I look at Louisiana Tech. I look at Utah State. I even think maybe San Jose State. I think it could be more appealing to a new conference. I'm not trying to be rude. I'm just telling the truth.
Yeah, I think that was the fan base of the Aggie basketball team.
That's the Brook and Teddy. That's the Brook and Teddy fan base.
You know, it's sad, and they need a fan base. We got some fans. The attendance at Northern New Mexico. Now that is an NAI team. Who's lost to a culinary school, apparently. But still, you know, people have to get out and support their team. They want to see their team win, and that was a great chance to see a team win. So,
sure.
You know, we talked about it. If the Aggies could get – if the WAC falls apart, maybe they really should make a run for the Sun Belt again. Good programs. Troy, you know, Florida Atlantic, Florida International is coming on a little bit.
I think that might be a logical home for them because also the WAC is not doing well. And if they lose some more teams, which would stand to be a possibility here – and then also their commissioner, Carl Benson, it sounds like he's going to go to the Sun Belt, so I could see the Aggies going his way. This is all speculation, just like all this realignment stuff is. We're just trying to connect the dots as only Brooke and Teddy can.
And North Texas has been a long-time rival, and they're still in the Sun Belt. Okay, Drake coming
up. Yeah, we spent too much time on the realignment.
Bracket Buster, Drake's coming into town. They're from Des Moines, Iowa. They're unis. They sort of look like Duke, if you're looking to figure that out. They're 14-12. They've lost 5 of their last 7.
Sure.
Their number 2 scorer and rebounder, though, Bill Simons, has been out with mono nucleosis. The Aggies are going to prepare as if he's playing, but we're not sure.
Did you pronounce that right?
Nucleosis. Mono. I'll just say mono. That's why I'm a writer.
I heard they're a good team. Nick Brooks said their number 2 leading scorer is out of that. They do have their leading scorer's name is Ravonte Rice, and I like that name. What can I say? Should be a good game. They come here Saturday. Aggies coming off a big win at Utah State. I think from a psychological and mental standpoint, it was big because Utah State's been a thorn in the side to NMSU. Not the Aggies haven't beaten them either, but particularly up in Logan, Stu Morrill's the coach. I thought that was a quality win. The Aggies, I don't think they're the best team in the WAC because I think Nevada is. I do think the Aggies could beat them in a one-game playoff, which would be the case if they met in the conference championship game if the Aggies finished number 2 or number 3, which seems like a lock at this point. I just booked it.
All right.
Folks, thanks for checking us out as always. Sun News Facebook, Twitter, Elsa Sun, Dash News, all day, every day. Have a great day.